Right, so welcome to a new episode of my Kerbal Space Program career mode videos, where today we are starting at the launch pad with now placing this space music while still being below the clouds. Might feel a little bit wrong, but most of this clip as of now is going to take place in space, where we are finally launching the this commercial satellite launcher spacecraft that I had in storage for quite a while, which still dates back to the not so successful commercial satellite launches. But this time it is going just like clockwork, or it also was on the first attempt, except for the fact that for some reason the game did not like two satellites to be launched at once and only counted one of them for whatever reason. But this time it is only one satellite, and again, just like clockwork, reaching the required orbit. And once we have achieved this, we will head over into the VAB. As of now, where we will load the Octo Orbital Probe from my Steam Workshop and put the Junkyard 1.2 meter rocket underneath it. You can find both of them in the Steam Workshop, and I will put the link in the description. And we are building altogether three of this exactly similar, with different names, and one without experiments and the launcher turned 90 degrees. And so yeah, we are now in the tracking station, because our first goal will be to fly by the Moon and Minmus as required by one of our contracts, and I want to do both of them in one launch. And then finally, after Minmus, like to use Minmus for the very last bit of gravity assist to then reach interplanetary space. So this will be the Kerbal probe and or the Kerbal probe and the first spacecraft to reach interplanetary space. And of course, in to be able to do this, the Moon and Minmus will have to be in the proper alignment, which I just chose entirely based on guesswork, like looking, is it looking good? Maybe the way the Moon's gravity will slingshot us, this might be pointing towards Minmus now, and it was more or less, but yeah, you will see. And now, yeah, there you can also see the first spacecraft, the Kerbal probe, being completed and now rolling out to the launch pad, and the next three, the Moon probe, the Minmus probe, and then the RA2 relay satellite, being still under construction. And of course, with missions like this, where I'm flying multiple missions or with videos like this, where I'm flying multiple missions at once, it really comes in handy that I'm doing the commenting in the while editing the video. So now we are at the launch pad, and yeah, deactivating all other crafts in order to make it a bit more easy to keep everything inside, and selecting the Moon as target. So we can go now, and once again time lapsing, this time at 4x speed and not 8x, so you will still have the original sound file from the video, but it just sounds a bit weird at 4x speed with the and catch up. The rocket sounding like strong wind, and then the staging making this chuffing noises and everything. So we are now on a suborbital trajectory and head towards the circulation burn in the upper stage, which will be very soon completed, as I can see here in the storyboard. And yeah, having circularized the orbit, we will now take a look. You can still see the orbit or the required orbit for the polar satellite, which also was not very successful when Yeah, now placing the maneuver, which was not very successful in the commercial satellite episode. Now placing the maneuver to achieve the flyby of the moon and then the gravity assist to slingshot the probe on its way towards Minmus. Yeah, I can hardly see here in the small screen what exactly is going on. And of course, an alternative to this would be just to already save the video and then look at it on the big screen, but then again I would not have the storyboard at my hand. So now placing yet another maneuver node after having achieved the flyby of the moon just or of course, we did not have achieved it yet, but just to see what will happen after the flyby to get a rough idea on where to put the maneuver node and how much delta V we will need and everything. We are now burning the or doing the transmunar injection burn from the maneuver, and yeah, we'll have to stage because the upper stage is burnt out. That was the stage separator colliding with the payload fairing, and it's just space junk, so we don't really need to care. And yeah, having now reaching the flyby of the moon where you can see the resulting orbit after the flyby, and of course it was important to have this resulting orbit still within the Kerbin SOI, because if we were then shot out to on an escape trajectory and heading towards interplanetary space while actually wanting to go to Minmus, well, it would not be all that well. It might still be able to correct it, but definitely there's some better things that you can have now. Looking through the contracts for something, I know that the Kerbin World First Record Keeping Society is the yet another contract. There's actually two contracts going on to which require us to fly by the moon. And yeah, so now time warping, leaving Kerbin. Unfortunately, we can only or mostly see its night side until it eventually is gone completely. And then reaching to or arriving at the moon. I don't even know why it is time warping so slowly. But I think it had something to do with the Kerbal Alarm Clock mod. So yeah, and then or arriving at the moon. Unfortunately, to then also end up on the night side of the moon where everything is completely dark. And after having flown by the moon, we can place our maneuver node to reach Minmus, which I think we do not yet, as far as I can see here on the small screen. And yeah, I actually did not do any of the science experiments that we have on board because they are reserved for all the mystery goo. Container is reserved, of course, for Kerbal because we can only do it once. And so, anyway, there still is the moon probe coming up, which will do all the science around the moon. I think there was actually, as I can see, I did not pay attention to it until now that there is something wrong with the music, because with the very fast time lapses at 8 times speed, I put in some music and I just can see that for some reason some music also went where it is not supposed to go. So you will have like the game music and the music that I edited in mixing into some cacophonic, probably annoying noise mixture. So yeah, now actually you can see at the very high orbit how we are slowly orbiting towards Minmus and only can see Kerbin in the distance. And yeah, you can see at the top right the two contracts already completed to fly by moon, and contract to fly by Minmus will be completed very soon, I think. Actually, I wanted to speed up this part or even edit it out. I don't know if this might be the reason that there is the music where it is not supposed to be, and it actually was supposed to be here when everything is or when this is time-lapsed, and for some reason it got mixed up. This can happen when you revert your last step, and yeah, I definitely have to look into some better editing software than the Windows Movie Maker. But we have, as I can see now, with the three completed contracts, we have reached Minmus. And yeah, this was definitely supposed to be edited out or time-lapsed in some way, because yeah, it's just too long. So, but this part I remember, I wanted to have in the video where I was looking through some other contracts and actually accepting yet another contract to place a satellite into equatorial orbit of Kerbin. But I will not show the launch of this one. There will be one more commercial satellite launch in this video with the Polar satellite from the that was completely unsuc or completely failed in the commercial satellite video, because I just yeah, wanted to show here or just make things right, because I was a little bit embarrassed about how it failed badly. It did not fail catastrophically, but it failed badly. You can look into the episode if you want to. And yeah, also I think this is the one of the yeah, I accepted it, which is the was the contract to launch some tourists into space, because quite soon we will have the and yet another accepted contract. We will have the a three-seated spacecraft ready, which actually is will also be a bit safer than the Mark I that we have now. Of course, but now we only have the Mark I's manned spacecraft, which can seat only one Kerbal, but maybe already in the next episode we will launch the Mark II with two Kerbals, which is basically the Mark I and made it a bit bigger and everything. And then finally later we will have the KV-3, which is the Soyuz-style launcher, and everything is a bit safer on that one. It has a proper launch escape system and not just parachutes and everything, so we can or parachutes and stuff like that, so we can or ejection seats, I mean, and more parachutes in case one of them fails for landing, so it will be safe enough to take some passengers, and we can then launch this or we can do this tourism contract, which rewards quite a lot of funds. And except for apart from launching satellites, doing this space tourism is one of my favorite kinds of contracts, and also like placing flags and transmitting signs from some places is, or of course of the stock contracts, there's also some modded ones that yeah, you will see in the future episodes. And of course, collecting some science once we have reached interplanetary space. And I selected or set the antenna to require complete, because the batteries actually are not sufficient to transmit much science on this probe. So we will have to do this require complete and then slowly transmit the science or the data over time. So we are back at the launch pad. Now with the, as you can see, with the launcher turned 90 degrees, because we are once again heading to a polar orbit with the second attempt of the polar satellite. And again taking the launch to 4 times speed with the wind noises or the rockets that suddenly sound like wind. And yeah, now with this two strap-on boosters, which we did not have on the first attempt, of course it will be yeah, we will have the tiny bit of delta V that was that we did not have on the first attempt. So now coasting until Apoapsis, where we will then perform the circularization burn on the upper stage. as we are doing now. And I have to scroll down. Ah, it will scroll itself down to the storyboard so I can see what will happen. And then when increasing the upper upsis, the stage comes out and gets jettisoned, so we can activate the spark engine with the very nasty noise level. So maybe you cannot hear me talking and I think you can, because I set the time lapse to 8 times speed on this on reaching the required orbit, because of course this took a few minutes and I want to keep the video short. It will, as of now, I think will be something like 10 minutes remaining. It's now at 15 minutes or 16 minutes and it was something like 26 minutes long. So yeah, now we are in orbit. I just skipped the launch of our moon probe, because even if I really like the launch time lapses, it just gets a bit repetitive if you just do it over and over again in the same video. Especially if it is literally exactly the same rocket over and over again. So we are now placing the maneuver node in order to intercept the moon. And this is like literally the most routine thing that I could possibly think of. This transmoonar injection is actually, I was reading a book reading a newspaper while doing this and not paying 100% attention, as you will very soon be able to see. So now doing the transfer maneuver, and and looking at some contracts, but I think as long as this this part of I forgot once again to accept the contract to orbit the moon, and I was doing now where I wasn't 100% sure if it even is valid, because of course I'm not used to talk that long, first of all. And sometimes you have to accept the contract before you actually build your spacecraft, so I wasn't even sure if this would be like valid, stupid German accent. So yeah, now heading towards the moon. And having reached the flyby, and I was time warping a little bit too fast, so we are already almost out of the sphere of influence of the moon, so we will burn unnecessary much delta V in order to actually insert into moon orbit until we have burned too much and are on a suborbital, on a very high and very elliptical suborbital trajectory. And the nasty thing with the suborbital trajectory, so this very elliptical orbits, is that at the upper apsis you are like literally almost standing still, so you get tempted to time warp really fast, but I didn't, and suddenly it is just plummeting down, and luckily it was time warping so fast that it just bashed through the moon without even, yeah, like touching it, because of Kerbal Space Program logic. So luckily we did not lose the probe, even if we should have. I was then burning a little bit radial in order to lower the apoapsis and raise the periapsis over the surface or near to the surface, and then just do a little bit of burning prograde in order to finally reach orbit again from the suborbital flight over the moon. And then of course at later um Or not now doing the prograde burn, I can really not see much what is going on. And reaching orbit, and then later, of course, finally doing the science on the moon. I cannot read what the science reports say. And before then, time warping until periapsis, and this time without overshooting. Before then, now just slowly transmitting the science, and then at I don't know, we are already at the mix something up in the editing. We are now at the Minmus probe, which already is in orbit. And now, because the orbit of Minmus is inclined, we will have to time warp to the ascending. I think it is the ascending node, and then head or point to antinormal in the southward direction, in order to align the two orbits or to align the inclination, because the orbit of Minmus is inclined by 6 degrees. And I think that this actually is like the reason for Minmus to be in the game, for like introducing you to inclined and elliptical orbits that you just from while you're still in the Kerbin SOI think on, well, how can I get there before going to interplanetary spaceflight, because then you might be in orbit of Kerbal and oh no, how can I get there? The orbit is inclined. So yeah, after having placed the maneuver node for the injection burn and having burned out the upper stage, you can activate the very loud spark engine. So once again, maybe you cannot hear me. You can activate the very loud spark engine of the probe. And then slowly reaching to the very high orbit of Minmus over Kerbin. And yeah, I actually went a little bit overboard with that maneuver, so we will now have to point retrograde and very gently or be very gentle with the throttle in order to actually get to the velocity that we need. And yeah, now I actually was trying to capture the small blue dot of Minmus with the distant body enhancement mod, but for some reason it was not there. Maybe because Minmus was just about in the direction of the sun or of Kerbal, so the blue dot was not visible, and then just suddenly the real physical appearance of Minmus came out of nothing. And again, circularizing, you only need a very, very small amount of delta V in order to enter Minmus orbit. And again, doing science. And of course, the mystery goo pod doesn't yield so much science when you transmit it, but the Stilus was doing just to get some science from there. And so of course I think it was the Chatterer mod, or maybe the ship effects mod, will cause the antennas to do this SSTV signals when transmitting. And of course we will have to lower our apoapsis in order to get a more or less circular orbit around Minmus, and just take some nice pictures of the probe with Minmus in the background. And so yeah, all these contracts have rewarded quite a lot of funds. And to do a little understatement, we are at way over 1 million funds, I think almost 2 million, so it is more than enough to upgrade the research and development department, which is by far the most expensive facility, and upgrade the astronaut complex, so Kerbals can go on EVA and some other places than just the surface of Kerbin, And with the upgraded research and development department actually can take surface samples when they are there, and more importantly, we can now research paths or research nodes that have more than 100 science points to be researched, with up to 500. And of course also upgrading all other facilities except the observatory from the research bodies mod, but I will do a special episode only on the research bodies mod sooner or later. And of course you cannot see any facility upgraded yet, because they with the Kerbal construction time, upgrading them takes quite a while. But in the next episode, where I'm not 100% sure yet what I'm going to do, you will see the upgraded facilities. Maybe we will launch the Mark II spacecraft and then go onto the first orbital EVA in space, or maybe we will launch some probes to the surface of Moon and Minmus, or maybe the first real interplanetary probes to Luna and Eve. I don't know yet, because with the quite large amount of funds that was remaining, I literally put a shitload of a build list with I don't know how many vessels for all the upcoming space flights. And yeah, you will see one of them in the future, in the next episode. And I hope to see you there again. And as usual, if you have enjoyed the video, you can feel free to leave a like and subscribe to my channel. And also check out my main channel, which is linked here and linked on my channel channel page. And I hope to see you again in the next episode.